Hey everybody, welcome to the shop. It's Friday afternoon and we've just cleaned up and time for two short things. I got a package, finally. I had to fight with the post office to get this because, and we can learn from this, it was addressed to Agent Jay-Z and then the address for S&S Turbines. So I don't have any ID that has Agent Jay-Z on there, and the post office was not interested in searching a phone. If you look at my real name in Google, you'll never find me. I'm not even there. There are many people that are much more successful than I am with my name. But if you Google Agent Jay-Z, or Agent Jay-Z, all one word, it's pretty easy to find me. Okay, so this thing is from Cyprus. That's all I know. Lemessos, Cyprus. I can't read the name or anything else because it's in, I'm assuming, Greek. It looks like Greek to me. But I got some cool stuff. These are all laminated, very nice. This is something, 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 1968, something, 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 2017, something, something. I'm sorry, I can't read your name. It's very cool, laminated. Look at that, will you? It's very cool. We'll show you all these. And then we have, this is really cool. This is something, something. It's a very cool logo. I'm going to put this one up on the wall, I think. That's cool. And this is some educational material. This is basic, what you'll see in most textbooks, jet engine fundamentals, kind of thing like that. Hero's steam engine. I think Hero was a Greek, so that would be pretty cool. And this is actually a reproduction of that jet engine that we've seen, the turbojet, in a diagram in my video called Jet Engine Diagrams 1. This is more stuff, more interesting things, but I can't read any of this. It's in a language unfamiliar to me. Let's make sure we get that logo there, that logo. Soon we will be offering merchandise, but not just yet. We're working on it, working on it, working on it. And I almost don't want to show you this one, but I'm going to. I want people to comment in the comments, what is wrong with this picture? Just basically, quickly. Okay, now, the last but not least, definitely not least, this is kind of cool. Look at this. I've never had one of these before. See what that is? Wait, let's see. It says, to Mr. Agent Jay-Z, Chief Master of the Professors, Engineers about the Jets, Machines, Engines. I think that's a translation, but it'll do. This is an honorary degree, and that is very cool. This is going on the wall. So thank you, the person that sent me this. And if you're the person that sent me this, please comment in the comments so we can communicate a bit more. I have no idea what your name is or anything, because I can't read any of this language. I can't read your name on the package that you sent. So yeah, thank you very much. It's very cool, super cool. Okay, going on the wall. And you can see that things are progressing. Can you see that? You can see that we've added the afterburner fuel control. This is the thing that everybody thinks is just the hose that dumps fuel in the tail end of the engine, which is completely wrong, and you know that now, so I won't go on about that. This is the afterburner fuel pump, and the fuel filter, and the fuel control, and it goes back to the afterburner. This is the fuel filter for the main fuel pump, which is underneath that rag. This is the main fuel control, and this is a transfer gearbox with oil pumps, scavenge pumps, nozzle area control, etc., etc., etc. So we're making progress. Now, we've had the turbine, has just been balanced by Big Al at S&S Turbines, and it's gonna go up in there real soon. Cool. So today's main question is, I was having a discussion earlier today about compression and heat and work and power of the compressor, the turbine, all that stuff. And the person said that they assumed that the pressures weren't too high to avoid, what did they say, pre-ignition, detonation, knocking, all those things. Why don't jet engines knock or pre-ignite? Well, Let's see. It's very easy. It's very easy. At no time in a jet engine, at no time is there ever fuel and air mixed together that's not already on fire. Well, that's not quite true. Just a second. I'm going to go grab a fuel nozzle. All right, we have a fuel nozzle from an Arenda Type 14, similar to that. That's a Type 10. Type 11, actually. No, it's a Type 10. Doesn't matter, they're all very similar. Okay, so this is just the biggest fuel nozzle we had. And the fuel is sprayed out of the orifice at the end of this nozzle. There's these little holes in the back that air goes in there and mixes with the fuel. So for about, let's say for fun, let's say 10 millimeters. For 10 millimeters, there's a spray of fuel coming out of this thing, lots of it, a couple gallons a minute, and the flame front is right about there. So this fuel is injected into hot, high pressure air that's already got fire in it. You're spraying a fire with fuel. So you want this stuff to be burning as soon as possible. There is no time, at no time, are you waiting to do something with this mixture before it's supposed to be burning. So therefore, it's impossible to have pre-ignition or knocking or detonation in a jet engine. If you were to introduce the fuel in a spray into the inlet air and then compress it, a little bit like some supercharger systems. Some supercharger systems in cars compress the air, I guess a lot of them, all of them, compress the air, and then in that compressed air plenum, before it goes into the cylinder, fuel is sprayed. So for a while, you have a traveling mixture of air and fuel at pressure that gets introduced into the cylinder and then compressed more and then burnt, not exploded, to make your power. So you never want to have the fuel in the plenum catch fire, or the fuel in the compressing cylinder, piston and cylinder combination. You don't want it to catch fire on its own. You want to ignite it at the right time. None of that matters in a turbine engine. The most important thing to remember is they're not piston engines. I mean, hey. Look at that. There's a diagram, a new diagram we have. Does that look like a piston engine to you? Right, that way, okay, there. This, for you Canadian history geeks out there, this is the Arenda Iroquois in cross-section. Oh, freeze frame that, buddy. Oh, look at that. One of the most powerful pure turbojets ever created. And the fuel nozzles are right here. So if you could have the fuel on fire coming out of the fuel nozzles, that'd even be better. But just from the way things work, you're spraying the fuel into the air and it's got a flame front. As soon as it can, it's burning. As soon as it can be burning, it's burning. So you never have to worry. You never have to worry about pre-ignition or knocking. And another way of illustrating that or explaining that or talking about that or babbling on about that is when you're going to go start a jet engine. This is critical. You need to get the RPM up so you get the air. The air is flowing through the tube, the engine, the machinery. Lots of air. Then you put the igniters on. Tick, 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 tick. So your source of ignition is now happening with the air. The last thing you introduce is fuel. Because you want the fuel to be instantly on fire. You don't want it to build up. If you run the starter, get the engine up to RPM, and give it a bit of spray of fuel, and then hit the igniters, it's going to explode. You're going to have a bad day, and you may ruin your engine. So I know that's what you would do with a 1970 Polara slant 6. You're trying to get started out in the field. But not with a jet engine. You have to have your ignition going first so that as soon as the fuel is there, it's on fire. That's the most important thing. So again, as I always say, they're not better than piston engines. They're just way, way different. There is no cycles. There's no drawing in of the fuel, compressing the fuel, burning the fuel, and exhausting the exhaust. There is There is. Let's see if I can do this backwards. This is the front. Yes. That's the front. It is. So there's the drawing in of the air. That's always happening. Always. There's the compression of the air, which is always happening. There's the burning of the air and fuel, which is always happening. And there is the expansion through the turbine producing power, rotational power, to run the compressor, which is always happening. And there's the residual thrust out the back to push the airplane forward, which is always happening. There's no ka-chugga, chugga, 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 chugga. There's just a whoosh. Yeah. Yeah. Even better than a rotary. I know rotaries don't have up and down, back and forth, reciprocation, but they still have strokes. They have pulses of power. My first car was a rotary. And the jet is continuously doing all of them. If you've got a four-stroke engine and a two-stroke engine, piston engine, and you've got, what would a rotary would be like a one-third stroke, wouldn't it? It's like three power strokes, three power pulses per revolution. Something like that. This would be a zero stroke or an infinite stroke. There's continuous smooth power all the time and the fuel is burning instantly. I forgot to mention this, but the J79, which we're most familiar with here, has about a 10 to 1 compression when it's running at full RPM. Which, you know, that's not bad. But the LM2500 has a compression of 18 to 1. So if you had your gasoline piston engine running at 18 to 1, you'd probably have pre-ignition and problems. And modern turbofan engines, sorry about that, modern turbofan engines have compressor ratios, when they're running at maximum speed of 40 or 50 to 1. 40 or 50 to 1. And the air gets extremely hot and fuel, jet fuel, diesel, gasoline, would instantly burst into flame as soon as it encounters air like that, which is what we want. So there's no such thing as pre-ignition in a jet engine. Well, we won't get into the complicated dry low emissions or DLE combustors and industrial engines. There they do have a pre-combustion swirling chamber to lower emissions. Never mind all that. There's no time in your jet engine where there's a mist or a vapor of fuel mixed with air that's not supposed to be on fire. And if it's not on fire, it's going to be, and it's going to cause a problem. Yes. So on that note, on a Friday, it's time to go home. It's not even beer 30, it's beer 59. Thanks for watching.